So this is going to be a video about why the Mcat is so important. And for those of you watching this video, I'm sure maybe at some point you're going to be taking the Mcat, or you're thinking about it, thinking about going to medical school. Maybe you have even taken it once and are planning on taking it again. And you're probably wondering, why is it so important that you have to take the medical college admission test, and why they emphasize it so much? Really, I'd say there's like three or four main reasons. And the first one is that medical colleges are really trying to find a way to gauge your ability to take in new information and then utilize that on an exam in real time when you're focusing on an exam, because that's kind of what you have to do in medical school and as a physician, I guess. And being in medical school now myself, I would say that that's actually pretty important. And I know it's kind of unfortunate. You're probably thinking, like, why do I have to take an exam where I'm getting scored and I'm being compared to other people? You know, that kind of sucks because, like, you had to take an ACT as well for college. And you're probably thinking, hey, the MCAT's probably the last exam I have to take. I get into medical school and that's it. That's actually completely wrong. You should definitely look up things that you'll have to do in medical school, because you'll have to take board exams, like step one, step two, the USMLEs, those kinds of things. Maybe you've heard these words before, but definitely look these things up, like the United States medical licensing exams. You have to take three of those. And then depending on what specialty you do, you'll have to take the board exam for that specialty. And so really your ability to take board exams is really crucial. It started at the ACT, and I guess it really starts at the MCAT, because again, that's their way to gauge your ability to take in new information and utilize it. Number two is gonna be, I know this is gonna sound pretty superficial and kind of, again, unfortunate, but a number score sort of gives them a rough estimate to compare you to other people, compare you to your peers that are taking the exact same exam that you are. Because let's look at it like this. Somebody that they have from Harvard versus somebody from UCLA, those are two different schools and those are two different GPAs that they got from those two students, right? So they need some number score that everybody's taking that same exam. How am I supposed to compare these two kids? It's this number, and it's just a quick way to really compare students. Now, having said that, I am not going to sit here and tell you you have to destroy the MCAT in order to get to med school and be in the highest percentile, because that's absolutely not true. Like, you are being looked at as a whole candidate, okay? But again, it's just a way for them to gauge, using a number, being able to use a percentile to see where you stand. And again, I know it may sound unfair, but you're applying to one of the most competitive graduate schools in the nation, and a lot of people are applying to it, and so they need to know where you stand. So I'm not going to sit here and apologize to you for that. I mean, you are applying to school, to medical school, so that was on you. Okay, so the next thing is that the MCAT tests you on the basic sciences, which includes the biology section, which also includes biochem, the chemistry section, which includes physics, psychology, which is like social sciences and behavior as well, and then there's the verbal reasoning, or like the critical analysis part of the exam. And so the next main thing is that these are testing sort of your basic knowledge of biology and physics, and now psychology as well. Sort of the basic knowledge of those kinds of things, because I guess having been through med school, I would say, I kind of did require a basic knowledge of things. Like, I need to know what a cell is. I need to know, like, some of those basic chemistry pathways, and some properties in order to understand some of medicine. I wouldn't say that's, like, a huge part, but, like, which is why, like, a lot of the MCAT is giving you information and making you analyze it and answer questions. You know, a part of it is knowing outside information, of course. Actually, a big part of it is knowing basic sciences yourself, like through those discrete questions, which straight up asks you certain questions and you have to bring that up from memory or having studied it. So I think that's like a small part of it as well. And then speaking of the verbal reasoning, critical analysis part, some argue that that's one of the most important parts, and that's like really giving you brand new information, asking you to interpret an author's or some sort of like argument inside that passage and then answering questions. And they say that that's really important. Having been through it, I would say, yeah, that is really important. Like, you should be able to take new information, analyze it, and then sort of, I guess, I can't put this in any better terms, but diagnose with the information that was given to you. Okay, so the last thing that I would kind of say is, can you study for an exam? Can you put things aside, put a little bit of your social life aside, put other things aside, and just study for an exam? For a board exam that you have to take, because like I had stated earlier, you're going to be having to take board exams throughout medical school and even during and after residency. You know, getting a GPA and doing classwork over the span of 3 or 4 years during undergrad is one thing. You're given a lot of time. I'm sure a lot of your classes are super hard, but you have more time, I guess. But then something like the MCAT, maybe you're allotted maybe 3 or 4 months, maybe even less than that, to study for a big exam. And they're really, that's one of the big questions they have to ask is, can you study for a big exam and learn all of this information? So that's really, I think those are the main points and why they're having you take this exam and why it's so important. I really think you guys should try to do well on it. But don't forget the other things. GPA is really important. Extracurricular activities, the reason why you're going into medical school and getting some medical experience, you know, getting out there, volunteering, being a medical scribe. That's something that I had done too. I have a video on it as well. If you guys have any other topics that you want me to talk to, having been a pre-med, having been a medical student, now I'm entering residency soon, please go ahead and ask me and subscribe as well, because that'll give me a gauge on whether or not I'm doing these videos well. And again, give me some topics and I'll totally answer your questions. You can like comment below and stuff like that. So good luck.